Good morning guys, today we can see transplantation immunology. In this session we can see the last portion of transplantation. Today we can see the clinical manifestations of transplantation. We have already heard about graft rejection reactions, the mechanism of rejection, different types of grafts, primary and secondary rejections, etc. in the previous classes. We also heard that the rejection depends upon the type of organ or tissue involved and also the immune response involved. Three types of rejections can be seen: hyperacute rejection, acute rejection and chronic rejection. First we can see hyperacute rejection. It occurs very quickly. The rejection, it is occurring within the first 24 hours after transplantation. Here the vascularization of the grafted tissue does not occur. Before that, rejection occurs. Rejection is caused by pre-existing host antibodies. In the serum, this antibody combined with antigen to form antigen-antibody complex. Complement system get activated. This results in inflammatory reactions, preventing the vascularization of graft. And the pre-existing antibodies in the recipients may be due to following reasons. It may be due to repeated blood transfusions, repeated pregnancies, and also exposure to a previous graft. In all these cases, we can see hyperacute rejection. And a special type of hyperacute rejection is accelerated rejection. Here, pre-existing antibodies may be specific to blood group antigens of the graft, and this is a very less frequent form of hyperacute rejection and is termed as accelerated rejection. Second one is acute rejection. Acute rejection is mediated by T cells. This begins about 10 days after transplantation and is characterized by massive infiltration of macrophages and lymphocytes at the transplanted site, and the result is the complete rejection of the graft. Third one is chronic rejection. Chronic rejection occurs months and years after transplantation. It may occur even after 10 years of transplantation. Mechanism include humoral and cell mediated immunity. It is difficult to manage with immunosuppressive drugs and may necessitate another transplantation. That's all about clinical manifestations. Next we can see immunosuppressive therapy. Two types of therapies are utilized: general immunosuppressive therapy and specific therapy. First we can see general immunosuppressive therapy. The speciality is that it is non-specific. It results in complete suppression of responses to all antigens. This may lead to serious and life-threatening complications in the recipient. Patients taking long-term therapy are at a high risk of cancer, hypertension and metabolic disorders. And the main therapeutic agents employed are mitotic inhibitors, corticosteroids, fungal metabolites and total lymphoid irradiation. First we can see mitotic inhibitors. Imuran or azathioprine can be used. It's a potent mitotic inhibitor. It is given before, after or after transplantation. It acts on the S phase of the cell cycle. Cells which are in S phase are affected. It can block the synthesis of inosinic acid and it's a precursor of purines, thereby diminishing the B cell and T cell proliferation in response to graft antigen. Second one is cyclophosphamide. It's an alkylating agent. It gets inserted into DNA double helix and get cross-linked, resulting in the complete destruction of DNA chain. This is given at the time of grafting mainly to block T cell proliferation. Third one is methotrexate. Methotrexate is a folic acid antagonist. It can block purine biosynthesis. One drawback is that mitotic inhibitors act on all rapidly dividing cells which are involved in immune response, leading to serious side effects. Then second one is corticosteroids, mainly prednisone and dexamethasone are employed, potent anti-inflammatory agents. These drugs are given to the recipient along with a mitotic inhibitor to prevent acute rejection. Third one is fungal metabolites. Cyclosporin and rapamycin are fungal metabolites showing some immunosuppressive properties. And they can block the activation of resting T cells. And they can also inhibit the transcription of genes encoding interleukin 2 and interleukin receptors, which are essential for the activation of resting T cells. Third or fourth one is total lymphoid irradiation. Here, the lymphocytes, they are extremely sensitive to X-rays. So, X-rays can be used to eliminate lymphocytes in the graft. Here, the recipient receives multiple X-ray exposures to thymus, spleen and lymph nodes before transplantation. Bone marrow, it is not subjected to X-ray. So, the lymphoid stem cells proliferate and newly formed lymphocytes are more tolerant to graft antigens. That's all about generalized therapy. Hope you all understand. Then second one is specific therapy. Here we are using monoclonal antibodies. Monoclonal antibodies are produced against some of the surface receptors of the cells of our immune system. For example, monoclonal antibodies can be produced against CD3 of the T cell receptor complex. You know that CD3 is playing an important role in immune response along with T cell receptor. So, this may result in rapid depletion of mature T cells. We can also use monoclonal antibodies for the prolonged graft survival. And these monoclonal antibodies, they may be specific to some cytokines such as tumor necrosis factor alpha, interferon gamma and interleukin 2. By applying this type of monoclonal antibodies, the graft will survive for a long time. Then second one is blocking co-stimulatory signals. We have already heard about immunological synapse, that is the antigen presenting cell and the T cell, they will interact in the immunological synapse with the help of co-stimulatory pairs. That is, for the powerful interaction, co-stimulatory pairs are essential. Blocking of these co-stimulatory pairs makes the T cells unresponsive. That's all about specific therapy. Next, we can see the immunological tolerance to graft without immunosuppressive drugs. In some cases, we can see immunological tolerance without immunosuppressive drugs. Such cases are if the grafting is done to sequestered site. We have already heard about sequestered antigens, that is hidden antigens. That is, sequestered sites, they are hidden from the immune system. That is, they are not exposed to immune system. So, the immune system is not aware of these sites. So, the graft will be safe in such sequestered sites. As a result, or such type of grafting does not require an immunosuppressive drug. Second one is early exposure to alloantigen. That is, the recipient get an early exposure to this graft antigen. It can also provide immunological tolerance to the host. Third one is lack of alloantigen. In the case of cartilage heart valve transplantation, here there is no alloantigens. So, these also provide immunological tolerance, or there is no immune response as the alloantigens are lacking. In these cases, these immunosuppressive drugs are not necessary. Next, we can see clinical transplantations. Nowadays, we are hearing many types of transplantations, or the transplantation is very popular when compared to olden days. The main organ transplanted is kidney, bone marrow transplantation, heart, lung, liver, pancreas and skin transplantation can be seen worldwide nowadays. In bone marrow transplantation, we can see a complication called GVHD. GVHD means graft versus host disease. This is occurring, or this is associated with bone marrow transplantation. It affects 50-70% of patients. It is mainly occurring when the donor T cell recognizes the alloantigen of the host cell. Here, the host cell antigen is recognized as a foreign antigen by the donor T cell. Activation and proliferation of this donor T cell and cytokine production leads to inflammatory reactions in skin, gut, and liver. Here, In severe cases, gastrointestinal hemorrhage, liver failure, generalized erythroderma of the skin, etc. occurs. This can be prevented by using immunosuppressive agents such as cyclosporine, methotrexate, monoclonal antibodies, etc. The specialty is that here the immune response is mounted by the graft against the host. Here the immune response, it is mounted by the graft against the host antigen. That is the specialty of graft versus host disease. Hope you all understand this session. Thank you.